If you think it's time to step into the world of Stable Diffusion and create beautiful, unique designs, then this video is for you. Hi, I'm Roslav from NechEmpire, and in this video I'm going to show you how to bring out your inner artist and create incredible digital artworks using the free text-to-image generator called Mage. For me, Stable Diffusion is the ideal model to get the most of my artistic endeavors. And it doesn't matter whether you are a pro or beginner. This image model makes creating visuals simple and efficient, regardless of your experience level. And now it's time to take a look at the free tool with the latest Stable Diffusion 2.1 model to give your artwork an impressive boost. Let's take a look at Mage, a tool you can use even without registration and absolutely free of cost. While it's possible to use this tool with the Stable Diffusion version 1.5 without signing up for an account, to experience the newest version 2.1, a free account is necessary. It's definitely worth taking advantage of this great opportunity. Before you start taking advantage of this tool, it's essential to understand how it works in terms of pricing. As mentioned before, the tool is free and provides unlimited image generations. However, there is also a basic plan where you get access to multiple tabs in your browser at a price of only $4 per month. This makes it perfect for people who need to work on multiple designs at the same time. And the Pro plan takes it one step further, providing you with 10 plus fine-tuned models that enhance your design. This plan comes with a monthly rate of $15. So I think it's time to go back to the Mage image generator. Upon visiting the homepage, you are immediately asked to enter your text prompt into the prompt bar, which is clearly the most prominent feature on the screen. As you can see, this bar dominates the web page. Underneath the bar, there is a View Options button that lets you pick from a variety of fine-tuned models to use for your designs. This makes it easy for newbies to create images, but if you want to get the most out of the tuned models, you will need to be a Pro Plan user. In the subsequent section, you can adjust the image aspect ratio by alternating width and height dimensions. Additionally, the quality and guidance scale are major factors when it comes to generating images. The quality indicates how many steps the AI takes to create an image, which in turn determines the detail level of the image. More steps taken will produce a higher level of detail. On the contrary, the guidance scale means how much freedom the AI is given while following the text prompt. The higher you set it, the less freedom it has when it comes to being creative. If you are just getting started, these features are all you need. Zoos with more experience can head to the advanced section and custom their image using the adjustable bars for a more precise result. Furthermore, you can enable privacy mode to generate your visuals and keep them from being copied by the general public. Instead of talking about the seed function, I will mention the negative prompt. You can use this feature to exclude certain elements from your generated images. For example, if you are creating a mountain scene but don't want to have the sun or trees in it, simply list them into the negative prompt and you are done. So, enough talking, let's create an image from this prompt. Upon completion of the image generation process, a pop-up window will appear containing the generated image. With just one click, you can easily download the desired image onto your device. And you can even use the enhancement feature to make it even better quality if needed. Taking a closer look at the generated image will show you many details of the image. When you click on Show More, a negative prompt appears, so I think it's an incredibly helpful feature providing you with a quick access to more information. This image generator also allows you to rerun, remix, and re-image your own images. This will enable you to gain a new image whenever you choose to. Additionally, image-to-image feature will be activated when you use the re-image option. It is super simple to get this feature going. Just click on the image on the prompt bar and you will be able to work with image inpainting options. This way, editing your picture will be fast and easy, and you can make it look perfect with very little effort. With the Mage Image Generator, you can easily use the Stable Diffusion model with any additional cost. It is a great tool for those who are new to AI and image generation, and it is simple and straightforward to use. If you want to try the Mage, the link to the homepage of this tool is in the description of this video. So, thank you for watching, and if you have any questions, use the comment section and I will try to reply.